Hi there, today I'm going to show you how you can create your own Facebook pixel, and not only that, also how you can put that pixel to use by creating events and custom conversions that you can use for your ads. Let's do it. The first step is go to your Facebook Business Manager. You can go there by going to business.facebook.com and then make sure you select the right business here on the left. Next, go to your Events Manager. And then we want to create a new pixel. So I'm going to go here to click Connect Data Sources. As a source, we want to create a web source because a pixel is used on a website. And then we select Facebook pixel here. Continue, and we give this pixel a name. I'm going to use this pixel on my own consulting website as an example. So I'm going to give it the name Growth Consultant Pixel. And I will put it on my website, growthconsultant.com. Now we can choose whether we want to use one of Facebook's partner integrations or if you want to manually install the pixel. In my case, I'm going to show you how to manually install a pixel, even though for WordPress there is a partner integration. So I'm going to use install code manually. And now this is going to show me what the code base is that we have to embed. So I'm going to copy the code. And as I told you, I'm on WordPress. So on WordPress, there's a plugin called Header Footer Code Manager, which I recommend you to use. And this plugin, once it's installed, adds this menu item here, HFCM. I'm going to go there. And I want to say add new snippet. I will call it the Facebook snippet. We can leave the snippet side HTML. We want to use it site-wide. You can specify if you only want to show or fire the snippet on specific pages. And then I'm going to just insert the snippet code here. And that's it. I'm going to save that. And now we need to test, does the snippet actually work? And we have a way of Facebook testing that, but we also have another tool. So I'm going to just refresh this, my page. And there's a little plugin from Facebook called the Pixel Helper. And we can see that there is a pixel found and it's the Growth Consultant Pixel with this ID. We can double check if this is the right ID, but I believe everything is working as it should. So then we can go back to Facebook and continue down here. Next, we can choose whether we want to enable automatic matching. This will allow Facebook to get a bit more data from the website activity. I recommend you to activate the setting. Next, Facebook is asking us to add events using their event setup tool. We can do that, but we will first do the next step. So we'll go back to the events after. So you can see that we have to verify our domains. Ignore that there are two domains here. Obviously, this is the right one. And we need to verify these domains and add them to our business manager. So if we click here, it's going to send us to our business manager. And now we need to add our domain here. So I'm going to add the domain growthconsultant.com. And now it gives us a few different options on how to verify that this is our domain. I'm going to use the first option, which is this meta tag option. And basically, all we need to do is go back to our WordPress instance. And we can use the same tool that we just installed and just add a new snippet here. Call it Facebook verification. This only has to be on our homepage, but we can leave it on all pages. And just put that in here. And that should be it. So let's test if that worked. So at the first attempt, it actually did not work. I had to wait about 12 hours in order to be able to verify this. So you need to be a little bit patient until Facebook is able to recognize this tag on your page. But now you can see Growth Consultant is verified. And as the next step, we can now set up some events. So we go back to our events manager. And we can also see that our pixel now is fine. There's some issue here, which we can ignore for now. So what we can see on this page is that there is an event that's already firing, which is the page view. And that's actually all we need for at this stage. Based on that, we can create different conversions depending on where people land on our website. And that's what we're going to do now. You can also test if this event works if you go to test events and then just go to your website and see if this event appears in this list. So what we're going to do now is we are going to create a custom conversion, which is here on the left-hand side. And we are going to create it obviously for the pixel that we just created. And we're going to call it visited work with me page. There's a page here on my website under, which is here, which is called working with me. And I want to count a conversion, a custom conversion, every time someone goes to this page. Okay. So the conversion event is URL traffic, and it must meet a specific criteria where the URL contains. So if the URL contains this, then we have a conversion. So I'm going to create that, and that's done. Now, before we can create ads and use this conversion, we have to do one more thing. So we go back to our pixel, to our data sources, select the pixel we just created. And then under settings, we need to make sure that we share this pixel with our ad account. So this will send us to the pixel again. And now we add asset and we can select our ad account here. So this connects the pixel to the ad account. And so we can then use it for ads. Let me show you quickly how we can use this pixel in our ads. So we go back basically to our ad manager, and then we can create a new campaign, and we need to make sure we use a conversion campaign, which is generally what we would recommend because it's the most efficient way to spend your budget, telling Facebook what you actually want to get from your spend. And then here, if you go on the ad set level, you can see that you can now select a pixel here, and this is the pixel that we just set up. We will also be able to choose the event, or actually the custom conversion that we have defined, but we need to have had at least one custom conversion on this custom conversion that we set up. So you need to wait a little bit until you have this conversion, and then you can set up this conversion here as your goal. Okay, so this concludes our tutorial. Thank you so much, and please let us know if you have any questions in our comments. Thank you.